harm. We are here to love, not hate. We are here to create, not destroy. Good morning, respected Sister Margaret, our manager, Sister Lissy, our principal, Sister Rainy, our headmistress, sisters, teachers, parents, and my dear friends. Today, we the students of class 4A present before you a digital assembly on the topic He Our Earth, He Our Future.
Our Earth is the most beautiful planet in our solar system. As far as we know, Earth is the only planet in this universe where we get all the necessary requisites of life. No other planet has oceans, other life forms, and enough oxygen to comfortably breathe. Our planet is truly a magnificent place. But the healthy survival is possible for years and years. Only when we maintain the original condition of the Earth.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place was brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. There's a place where there's no hurt or sorrow.
Present day are not good. There is destruction all around.
Oh, I am on the verge of my death. Hunger, malnutrition, global warming, pollution, water crisis, all the evils have attacked me at once. I am dying. Please save me.
Don't worry, Mother. We humans will heal you and fashion your destiny with the awareness of the following measures.
Start carpooling or switch to bicycles to reduce the emission of greenhouse gases.
Say no to plastic bags. Always use cloth bags.
Check and repair machines regularly to reduce the emission of smoke.
Reduce, reuse, recycle.
Plant trees promote afforestation and promote deforestation.
Wow! Now I am sure that I am in safe hands. These little soldiers will take care of me and make it a better place to live in for future generations.
Human activities have affected the environment in a number of ways. For example, disposal of waste in the river and the inland bodies have polluted water to such an extent that it cannot be certified. The major cause for the damage of the environment are industrialization, population, urbanization, excessive use of fertilizers, pesticides, plastics, etc. We are forgetting that Earth does not belong to us. We belong to Earth. Today, what we are doing is we cut the tree, make a paper, and then write on the same paper, save the Earth. Isn't it foolish? Yes, it is foolish.
Good morning, all. Today, I'll be presenting a small conversation between pollution and future generation.
Of human consciousness. This is not an isolated event. If we want to truly succeed in healing the earth, we surely will need every person's effort, including yours. Alarms are sounding across all continents.
Earth is our planet. All living creatures on it are very useful and helpful. I love my planet and I am proud of its rich mineral resources. I shall always strive to be worthy of using them. I shall plant more trees, keep myself and my surroundings clean. I shall always use the products that are environment friendly. To my planet, I pledge my devotion. In saving this planet, alone lies my happiness and well-being.
Now, let us join our hands, close our eyes and say the prayer. Father, hold us in your caring arms. Embrace us with your life-giving love. Apply your resurrecting hands to our wounded business. It is your power that heals. It is your will that we live in good health. As our souls seek you, now, in our time of need, deliver us from our afflictions. Amen.
Father God, your word says the prayer of faith shall heal the sick. We come to you today in the faith that you heal us from every sickness, disease and illness. We receive our healing by faith in the Jesus' name. Amen.
The earth has music for those who listen. The very warm and peaceful morning to all. World that we are experiencing today is the result of a collective consciousness. And if we want a better world, we all must take the responsibility of creating it. The environment is not outside us, it is within us. The rivers are our blood streams. The trees are our lungs. We all are interconnected. What we do to the environment, ultimately, we are doing to ourselves. I am highly obliged to Sister Missy for providing this opportunity to the little ones and showcasing their talents. Thank you.
Gratitude is the sign of noble souls. A warm and graceful morning to all of you. I extend my most sincere thanks. The Almighty God for His blessing shower upon all of us. I am immensely thankful to Sister Lizzie, our principal, for providing us this opportunity and for being the catalyst that stimulated us to our best and standing as pillars of strength. An event like this cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling weeks ago. We are grateful to Sister Renu, our headmistress, for guiding us tirelessly throughout the preparation of the assembly. I would also like to thank our class teacher, Mrs. Sonia Mishra, who was a constant support and help, and under whose able guidance this assembly took place. Last but not the least, all the students of class 4A and their parents for giving their full-hearted support. Thank you once again.
I am the river flowing. I am the desert dry. I am the four winds blowing. I am the sunset sky. I am the forest breathing. I am the ocean wide. I am the storm clouds gathering. I am the mountain high. I am the earth. We are the children growing. You are the place we live. We are the seed you're sowing. We are the life you give. We are the future rising. We will be your voice. We will watch and learn from you. We will make